Trying to introduce myself. You may know me as a co-founder, for sure. Now I can also come to one. Just not mistaken for something else. Some of my colleagues even tell monkeys, you know, my wall, and some tattoos with a sensor. But actually, the guys that know me well know that I have a good talk. But guys, today it's not about me, and today it's about Drupal. And it's not only what we can do for Drupal, but also what we can do Drupal can do for us. And this will be our keynote after a couple of minutes. First of all, I want to thank all the volunteers. I want to thank Drupal Bulgaria, Drupal User Group Bulgaria for organizing this event. And especially I want to thank our sponsors, without which this event wouldn't be possible. And now I want to give the words to our core sponsor, Kandaru, to say something.
Maybe you know that W is a big global digital agency. We do many interesting projects in the best practices way, and expertise we are trying to do it in this way. But maybe you don't know that W is a company and actually engine of the global community in Bulgaria. I'm really proud that maybe in the last 55 years, the company we are already 7 years. I mean, in the last 7 years, we are, I'll say, the core and the main and the goal and continuing sponsor of most of the Drupal activities in Bulgaria. And that makes me really, really proud. So, So, everybody, we have heard Drupal, and everybody are willing to contribute about Drupal. I'm pretty sure I know many of you like the big Drupal contributors, but and of course some of you know that actually Drupal can give you much more. Actually, then we have Rachel, we're going to speak about what Drupal can tell us based on our contribution. So Rachel, please.
So Rachel is visiting the machine. I just wanted to update you about the schedule that we are having. Actually, we have one track in this room with sessions, regular session. In parallel, there will be a workshop for the stream tomorrow in the main hall. We'll have a lunch served in the food area next to the registration. So, and we will have a party outside after we finish the session today. And we have a night DJ. So we don't know who to be today. I will not like to meet the music. Okay.
It's my word for my child.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you for coming. Early this year, I ended up in a Twitter thing when somebody was going on about, the reason that why we ended up getting to tech is because they've got no role models. I'm actually a real exception to this. I kind of said something about that. I talked about people, women in tech, and start hoping to have my top at Drupal next year. And I'll start to run out of people now. So I just wanted to mention something about this amazing person that I don't know. It's an Austrian actress who started acting in Chickens of Frankie and following on Hollywood, Hedy Lamarr. So she was an amazingly successful actress. But she was also a bit of a tech wizard too. At the start of the Second World War, she invented, well actually co-invented, something that every single person in this room uses every day. You use it now, assuming you've got your phone on you. She invented something for the US Navy so that their torpedoes could be detected by German shipping. And that was a thing called frequency hopping. So frequency hopping, the actual radio control of the torpedo, would work in a way that the enemy couldn't block. It's also what makes Wi-Fi work better in buildings. It's what makes 3G work. It's what makes a lot of things that we use every day work really well now. And it's like it invented. But not being satisfied with that, she then went and she got kind of friendly with a guy called Howard Hughes, who's a big kind of aeroplane maker in the US around the time of the Civil War. And I just realized I'm just reading my tweet now. She not only got friendly with him, she learned aerodynamics and then gave Howard Hughes loads of tips of how to improve his airplanes so that they flew with less fuel. What? She not only learned an entire math subject, she then actually became a lead in making it actually move forward, which is kind of incredible. So I said, I think there's any time. I'm still going to do another one in Vienna. And I haven't thought who yet, so if anybody's got any ideas on what you want to do. Oh, this way. Okay, feel really bad doing an email. I'm a freelance developer back in the UK, although my clients tend to be all over. I've been working for a client in Vancouver for the last few weeks. I get involved in a mentoring, Drupal mentoring program. I sit for my sins on the community working group, which helps to, how should we say, deal with some differences that are bound to happen in a large community. It isn't just reality, you get a lot of people together, some of them may disagree. So I help to try and deal with some of that. Sometimes successful, but sometimes less successful, that's just nature. Okay, and around all over, probably going to travel up and handle it. I do like traveling around, and in fact, actually, I was here last year. I rode through on my motorbike, which is called Idris. It's a Welsh dragon. Maybe it just gets me calm. and yeah, so I loved it. So what I want to do before we move on is find out a few things about you. I don't really know the Bulgarian Drupal community that well at all. I know Valerie, wherever he is. Who is he? Okay. That's about it. So are you all employed in Drupal full time? Is that kind of what you do? Is that your big thing? Does anybody work freelance themselves like I do? Or yeah, you all work for big companies, small agencies? Big companies, yeah? Oh, this is going to be interesting then. Who works for small small agencies. Oh, look, I have you. Okay, who is what we would call a, I don't like the term junior developer, I hate it. Because actually, it makes people sound like they're less important. And actually, people who just come in to work in Drupal are the most important because they're more likely to be human beings. Okay, they're the ones that actually have the knowledge of not doing things and are not in there, use their knowledge. Or almost like their lack of knowledge is actually a really important thing. Say, if you, I'm not going to say the word now, but if who's just into Drupal, who's, yeah, good, yeah, this person knows things. Alright? The act of not being assimilated is a big deal. Yeah. Okay. Who counts themselves as a senior person in their business? You know? Yeah? Okay.
That's going to be interesting.
Okay. And who does coding? Who actually codes? And who does coloring in? Who does front end stuff? Yeah? Okay. Alright, cool. Alright. So, what I'm going to do is talk about how the things that happen in the Drupal community help you get better at what you do, grow as a front ender, whatever. Okay? Now, there's a word that gets banded around in the Drupal community a lot, and I have talked recently about this before. The word contribution. Okay? It's used a lot. People talk about contributing to Drupal. And I've got this app in the dictionary on Apple, you know, on my Mac, so it could be. But the word contribution always seems to come around the idea of a gift. Yeah? As though you're giving something. Right? And actually, the reality is it's not like that. It's a two-way thing. It's not just a gift. Yeah, you might be doing work and not getting paid, but that does not make it a gift. You get stuff back by doing it. Right? And that's what I want to talk about. Now, I'm going to base what I talk about today around one thing. And it's applicable and appropriate for you all based on what you've just told me. Yeah? You might not think it is to start with, but it is. Okay? Everybody here. Everybody, including those that are new to Drupal, are capable of being mentors to other people. Alright? And that's helping the guide, helping people move on, showing them a little bit. Everybody knows something that somebody else in this group does not know. Okay? So, we all, it's not about the code, it's about people. It's people that make good companies. It's people who make great websites. It's how people interact, how they're able to talk with each other, how they can bring their skills together that makes great things. Yeah? And the best companies are made up of the best people. And I'm sure you are trying that right now. Okay. And what we want to do is think about how to get those people. Now, I did send out some surveys around, I think it was quite early this year. Probably it was my tweets, so it depends on who followed me as to what came in. And I can't even read my own writing. I got some quotes back from people. I was asking company owners, the type of things, how they go about getting, I actually specifically said senior developers, but actually I meant anyone in a senior role. And some of the quotes that came back were interesting. They were things like senior developers are hard to find. They're expensive. They are,
I remember
how, and they're excited about to get hold of people costs money. The trouble is that means that you know, their rates are high and so so I said, well, how do you go about finding them? Do you use agencies? Do you use what? Well, some of the stuff that came back was around they listen to the community. Yeah? That's how they find senior people, is they listen to talking about things, who's talking about events, and so on. It's important. That's why you go talk at events so people notice you. Everybody. They, I said, so how do you develop people within your company? How do you actually bring people on? Because anybody who runs a company knows that if it's expensive to bring a senior person in from the outside, actually the best thing to do is to take the people you've got and help them grow and so on. Which is great. It's easier if you are a large company because you can put proper training programs in place and you can do lots of personal development work and all those things. It's great. You can have an HR person that does nothing but that. Human resources or whatever. I don't know what it's called in Bulgarian. I see there's something similar. Okay. A small company. That stuff gets hard. Yeah, it's expensive. It's difficult because you need the person, you need your people to be doing client work hours to scrape by. It's reality. Yeah. So we kind of have to think of how we can achieve some of those things when without. You know, it costing a lot of companies. And I mean, it got me thinking recently about my history and things that have happened to me that made me think, well, where are the places where I've had the best experiences? So when I started my Drupal career, I was started in a pharmaceutical company, which is great because there was loads of that type of growth, personal stuff. It was fantastic. But I left there and I started contracting. And one of the experiences I had when I first started contracting was I worked for an agency in the UK. Now, I'm not going to name the agency. That would be unfair. But the experience I had when I started was interesting because I kind of went into the office and not everything was really ready for me and they eventually kind of found me a desk, eventually. They found me a computer, which was nice. And they was like, oh yeah, you just need to follow these instructions to get it set up. And I pretty much spent the whole time I was in the office for the next 2 days doing nothing but setting up a computer. And nobody really kind of spent time with me. Yeah, not really spending time letting me understand the way the company works, making me think that it was somewhere special, somewhere where I had someone to talk to, and people to go to when I had questions. There was no one who made me feel as though I was valued, that actually I had skills that were worth having, and partly because of some of those things, it didn't really work. Yeah, I felt as though I was failing the whole time. I was working on some pretty big websites, but I didn't know. I was getting no feedback saying that I was doing a good job. Yeah? And even though I was doing good things, actually I didn't think I was. Yeah? Because that is nature sometimes, that is people's personal reaction a lot of the time, is you think that you're not doing as good as actually you probably are. Yeah. And then I discovered another place where my early experience of doing something and getting involved was quite different. And this was at a Drupal event. It was at Front End United in Copenhagen. Oh, yeah. 4 or 5 years ago, something like that.
More.
More?
Yes, no.
Gosh. Oh, no.
Last year.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I'm not really towards it. Okay. And I was, it was quite early in my Drupal career, for the best description. Yeah, it was about the same time as the agency I was talking about. So I didn't really know that much. The camp was, oh for God's sake, don't tell Martin, it wasn't very well organized. He was running around with 3G cards for everyone because the Wi-Fi didn't work. Which was brilliant. But out of all the chaos, the people that were there were brilliant. We didn't have many speakers because Morton. I love him actually, he's ace. He drives me nuts, but yeah, I love him. And we didn't have many speakers. The speakers we had were good, actually, they were very good, but we didn't have many. So we spent a lot of time with people doing contribution work into Drupal 8, which was still, at that stage, a bit of a mess. There was still a lot of things to do. And I'd never really done any of this before. And people sat down with me and helped me and found the things that I did know how to do and spent the time to build up my confidence, get me to do it, help review my work, even though it was only a few lines of code, and it actually wasn't. It wasn't really complex stuff looking back. Yeah? It was bits of CSS and bits of stuff like that, you know, really not very big deals. But they made it sound important. They made it sound you're doing something that will change something that a billion people will see. That's a big deal. Yeah? So I just remember one of the things I did there now. I changed, you know, when you do the file download thing where you can upload a file and then it will put the little icons next to the file type when you do it. I changed them from an image to a background image. And I entirely deleted some of the CSS, which is just like, I deleted like a whole file of just a joke that we didn't need. So every time you go and use Drupal 8 and a file download, that bit, I did. I walked out of there knowing that because that person, yeah, Ruben, said it mattered. Yeah, and Christina as well said, and they actually explained and thanked me for doing it. Now that is a big deal, and from that I grew. I grew as a person. I grew as a contributor. Yeah, I have contributed my time. I paid to go to Copenhagen. I sat down and worked reasonably hard and drank a lot as well, to be honest. but so yeah, I was giving. It was the gift thing, yes, but I got back far more than I ever gave. And that's why I have a problem with the word contribution. Being involved and working in the Drupal community is not just giving. Okay? So that was a big deal. And I realized that the actions of these people matters. Okay? It's a real thing. Not only did I get something out of it, but look, but Ruben got something out of it. Yeah? Because he learned more about how to give that feedback. Yeah? He got something out of it by helping me. Okay, so I've mentioned Ruben. I have actually mentioned Morton, and I think that I have a lot of time for the work that he did, not just in the code, but in the way he got an army of people to work on sorting out the front end. Still not perfect, don't get me wrong. And that's a big deal. I look up to him. I look up to Kathy, Jesse Tip, who taught me so much about what we're going to be speaking about today. She taught me everything about how you work with people, how it matters, how you go through the processes. I look up to Clara Ifrit on Drupal. She does amazing amounts of work and really investigates it. I look up to Angie, who, even though back in DrupalCon Munich, I went along to a sprint with Jesse Beach. I was just sat, I didn't have a laptop with me. And I was pretending to know what Jesse Beach was doing with JavaScript. I really didn't. she was doing something and it was way beyond me. And we were talking about tables and responsive tables. And I disagreed with Angie on something with regards to tape. I can't remember what I disagreed about. And we sat there and we debated it. And I'm an idiot. I don't know. I'm not some technological whiz person. I'm not. Yeah? And she is. She knows like stupid amounts of stuff that I'll never know. But she completely listened to what I was saying. Yeah? She treated me as her peer, which I still find ridiculous, but there you go. Okay? Yeah, I know. Imposter syndrome and all that. That matters. Yeah? Being treated like that and being treated as an equal, etc., matters. Yeah? I wasn't going to ask this, but actually I'm going to now. Would anybody else have a family story about anybody they look up to in the community? It's like, oh, go on then, yeah.
Actually, I've been visiting Drupal Cons for a while, but I never had a chance to go on sprints on Friday because we were traveling back. Actually, the first time when I joined the sprints, kind of. I mean, it was program one, 2 years ago, I think, more there. Maybe you can't remember the name.
No, I do.
We had like a few guys there, but quite experienced people. I wasn't really sure what I can do, because actually I was doing Drupal 8 because I didn't have time to begin Drupal 8, and things was closed on Drupal 8, and I was really wondering what I would do. But that's it. And quite a few guys like Alex Ford, they helped me to understand the basics. I mean, they didn't say, OK, plaintiff work Drupal way this year. This is pushing us, let's be ready for Drupal way. And they spend quite a few from their time to help me to understand some basic stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
What's a great experience?
Yeah. Anybody else?
Couple more about that. I have also such kind of experience in Drupal from Amsterdam.
Cool.
A session about Elasticsearch, and actually this involved me in the community. The guys from the Search API come and say, "Dylan, will you know architect the new Search API or we'll think about Drupal 8?" It was really fun.
Oh, yeah.
This is a way to actually also involve the community.
Brilliant. Cool. Okay, so these people are out there, and it's interesting, it's both of you and the people I've mentioned as well, the things that we've looked up to actually were not their prowess in code. Agree? It was about how they've interacted with things and that type of stuff. And that's fair to say, isn't it? Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? That matters because it doesn't matter at what level you think you do code at. Yeah? To be able to help other people, you don't have to actually even be as good at code as the person whom you're helping. Really. Okay? I know I manage it somehow. Okay. Right. So we've talked a lot, I have talked a lot about things that people that people look at. I've said that there's businesses that need these senior people, and we've talked about some amazing people that we look up to, and so on. And if a business wanted to take one of you, I think that person's got potential to be able to do amazing things and to help everybody else and senior people in the future, then it's that huge amount of effort I was talking about earlier. They've got to do all these things. They've got to find time to train them. They've got to find time to encourage them to do it. They've got to give them the exposure to go practice their skills. Because you don't read a book and then become a great senior person. It's not magic. You've got to go, well, maybe make mistakes. Yeah, keep on a few times. Yeah.
It's a process.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a process. Yeah. You slowly get better at things.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you've got to have that opportunity to do it.
For each point here, not just for the technical part.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
For the right person on each
level. Yeah. And
it's people.
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, you don't need to be the best person in PHP in a company to be the senior person. It's about how you are able to do all the things. Yeah? Okay. Now the thing is, we can all do this. Everybody here is capable of learning these skills. Yeah? And your companies can do as much as they can do. But what I would suggest is you need a place to practice them. Yeah? You need a place to try working with people rather than working with code. Yeah? And acting as mentors for new people and other people in different specialisms. Move specialism, mentoring something that you don't do. Goodness sake, it's brilliant. Yeah? Okay? You can do that. And we've got loads of things that you get out of coming along and getting involved in mentoring. So this is Annie Mack, who largely put a lot of the Drupal mentoring stuff. Thanks to her, she's amazing. And I'm embarrassed I didn't mention her earlier, but I forgot. So there's all these kind of leadership skills that you can pick up and you can learn and practice as part of getting involved in mentoring others. in the Drupal community. Don't bother waiting for someone to tell you to do it. No one's going to tell you to do these things. You just need to get up and do them. Yeah? So, Did I practice that? Okay. I'll put this one first. There's just some attributes that, sort of leadership attributes that I want to talk through. And the obvious one is you're going to be able to practice and learn more technical stuff by getting involved with others than anything else. While you're sat in your job doing commercial work, the reality of commercial work is you often end up doing the same thing over and over again. That is reality. And by getting involved in core contribution itself and actually mentoring others and helping others get involved, you get to do things that you would never do otherwise. Not only that, but you'll learn the technical stuff. Because if you learn how something works internally, you learn how to use it afterwards. Yeah? Okay? I would never have got my head around the internals of making the best use of a lot of the accessibility stuff in Drupal 8 if I hadn't actually been in there and done some of it. Although I have got some issues that need reviews, by the way, hint, hint. So, yeah, it's obvious you're going to learn some more technical stuff. I don't think that that's a surprise. Yeah? But if you get involved in helping others, and that can be between equals, etc., it can be helping someone new, it can be sitting and doing stuff with people that might be more than you, then you're going to learn other things. You're going to learn how on earth to create belief in others. Yeah? Because actually, it's quite hard. Yeah? When you're going to sit down and say to someone, should we work on this issue? And you find an issue and the issue being sat down with them, and they're going, oh, I don't know how to do that. And you can sit down and say to them, well, actually, let's break it down into little bits. We only need to do a bit. We don't need to fix the whole of Drupal 8. Yeah? One afternoon making one tiny change, yeah, even if it doesn't work, is a success because it moves one tiny thing on. And creating that belief that just taking small steps is success is a big deal because people will slowly build that up into making big differences over time. Okay? being able to actually work with people. Yeah? Sitting down and working out what drives individuals and how to work with them, how to encourage them, how to understand what's going on in their head is actually growing your capabilities. That if you wish to be a senior person, you're going to need. You're going to need to be able to do exactly the same thing with people that you work with back at the office. Yeah? I can't think of anything better than being involved in actually contributing code or mentoring others contributing code for actually understanding how Drupal as a project, i.e. the group of humans that make it work, functions. Yeah. Being able to get that concept of it and actually influence it as well, because if you're in there, you can change it. Someone can tell my government that as well, that'd be quite useful. It's kind of some sort of thing. You can change it. Yeah? You get in there, you become the person others are coming to for advice, you've got influence. Yeah? And you can show that to others. Also, it makes you think. Yeah? Getting involved makes you think. You can try things that are hard. And there's plenty of hard problems. Because sometimes the reality is, if you're doing commercial work, as I say, it can be repetitive. Go do something else as well. It's not that you're giving something away for free. You're getting something out of that. You're getting challenged, which makes you better. Okay? And also, standing up and saying, I'm going to do this, and then actually doing it is a skill that you're going to have to demonstrate to be taken seriously by a company as a senior person. It's just the way it is. Yeah? That's what they want to see. They want to see people own things and make them happen. And if not, deal with the consequences. It will drive you nuts. Doing mentoring and actually doing code contribution as well drives you nuts. Doing a lot of the different things in the Drupal community is hard. You have to keep pushing. And if anything can help develop even further your strength, it's got to be it, because it's not easy. Do think about getting involved in helping others, get them involved, learn how to do it, do some contribution yourself if you've not done it before, absolutely. If you have done it before, get involved in making the others come in and helping them. It's a big deal. You will grow as a person, as a contributor, as an employee, as a prospective future well-paid employee. Okay? And it works both ways, because it's like the business owners. Just giving people the time to go do this is good for the business, because it's giving your staff chance to go do something that is going to make the best half. It just is. Yeah? And it gives them the opportunity to go do hard things. It gives them the opportunity to learn all these skills that you want in your business. There's not one of those skills that people don't want in their business. Yeah? Oh, anyway. Okay. So, the obvious thing to say how to get involved is just come on to the end. Come on to Friday. If anybody is booking flights for others to Vienna, go home on Saturday. Don't go home on Friday. Friday is the biggest deal about the whole of DrupalCon. It's special. There's this really bizarre thing where there's hundreds of people sat in a room doing something good. And you definitely want to be part of it. Of all the day, Miss Tuesday. Tuesday, we missed that. Don't I've got Tom up saying that recently.
It is recorded.
No, I said it to Amanda Gonson, DA, just came out. Because of research. I forgot what I was going to say now. Yeah. If you're going to miss a day, miss Tuesday. The sessions are recorded, for goodness sake. Yeah? Watch them afterwards, watch them at home. But maybe it's Friday. Friday is special. Yeah. I guarantee anybody who can make it to Vienna or other similar events that have got mentor sprints. Or the online ones, the global training days and online sprints. We have sprint weekends 3 times a year now. Isn't it? Is it twice or three? I can't remember.
I think next year will be
two. Okay, I can never remember. They're great because you've got people online doing the same thing. You can't see them, but you know, still good. But it's special. You'll learn far more than you'll learn on any other day. Either as a mentor or as somebody who's actually being mentored. Okay. Oh, by the way, we have people at Vienna who mentor the mentors. And you'll notice them because they'll have them do colored tape all over their t-shirts. Including you.
I don't deny it.
Okay. So it's a big deal. It's a big deal. I didn't really want to try and cover all the subjects. So I thought to mention some others, but it's for you to look into them. So there are other things that are contribution where actually what you get back is far more than what you put in. I've got far more back from being part of and being involved in the community working group than I've put in. Although, I'll be honest, there's been a lot of heartache and a bit of crying occasionally when you're having to deal with interesting moments, shall we say. There's Copilot contribution, of course, which is kind of hard to talk about. You know, the Drupal.org website isn't magic. Somebody actually looks after that. They're not paid. We have some paid people, but a lot of the changes are actually made by the community. You can actually get a virtual machine set up if you wanted to make changes. The source code for Drupal.org is actually available. Yeah? If anybody wishes to finish work of moving Dreditor into Drupal.org, please do it. Please.
Especially if someone knows JavaScript.
Oh, yeah. Getting that work done has been a challenge. Yeah, it's not that big a deal, actually. Yeah, but Dreditor is a quite cool tool. It just needs simple version actually is built in because Dreditor doesn't work. Thank you. Lindsay, Lindsay is starting up the community spotlight again. She needs people to help. She needs people to write spotlights. This is little articles, blog posts, for want of better description, that people will publish about people in the community. Because it's one, it's a nice thing to do. It shows recognition, which is good. Which is a leadership attribute, of course. And it helps, you know, promote people and make charge more nerds. So get involved, talk to Lindsay, ask her what you can do to help. All of the diversity stuff, a lot of people get involved in that, which is great to see. Some of you already do this. Run your local meetups, put the effort in. Yeah, you get far more back than you put in. There's so many, I'm not going to mention them all. Okay. So I suppose now I've seen the time. Any questions? It's been a weird talk because I've been non-technical today, so it's been kind of weird, but
any hints, if somebody's new in Drupal, what to say to him or to her in order to get it into Drupal? Make the thing happen, the magic happen. Somebody to start like Drupal. I've been seeing things like people seeing Drupal and don't like it. How we can make this one happen also?
I would say that one of the great strengths of Drupal as I think, and one of the reasons I use it, I came from SharePoint, so it's not like it's going to be worse. It's the people. It's all of you, it's all of us, because we put the effort in to help each other. Yeah. if I have a problem, because I put the effort in to be part of that community, if I have a problem and I tweet about it or ask a question, I get so many replies. I'm never short of someone to explain to me how to do something. Yeah? Because, you know, you do it back, don't you? We all do it, you know, if somebody has a problem, you take the time out and you sort it. Yeah? With them. Okay, you don't have to tell them that this is fixed, you know, you can help them work through it, that's good. That is, I think, is stronger in the Drupal community than anything else. I think that actually the code is, well, I mean, Kurt's code is kind of, you know, it works a particular way, some of it's good, some of it's bad, some of it's kind of okay. There's bits I don't, well, certain bits I don't like. But my God, you lot are amazing. Yeah. I've got an interesting life, and it's, there are times when I've been quite down, and it's been the Drupal community that have got me through. Yeah, and so that's a big deal to me. That's why I'm kind of hooked. Okay, because of you lot kept me alive for a better description.
You're saying that if you have if you are introducing a new person to Drupal, so you say a bunch of things, and then you say, well, those are the channels of communication that you should use. If you have questions, use the community. So you have like a list of places where they should go.
Yeah, put in, it's a case of the put in, you get back what you put in. I mean, that's essentially what we've been talking about the whole way through there. So everybody has something that they can put in. Everybody. New people, everybody. Yeah? Because if a new person says, I don't understand how to do X, that is useful information to the project. Because we need to make that bit more obvious. If you don't get it, brilliant. Or not brilliant, but you know what I mean? It's kind of good. We want to know. Because somebody else in this room, or maybe the outside this room, can help fix that. I don't know. How many people here have changed the documentation on Drupal.org?
No.
I must admit, I've not done as many as I should. Nearly every page, she says, changing her mind very quickly. Nearly every page on Drupal.org is editable by you. If you don't understand something, sit down with somebody who does and change the documentation. We work on a principle of it's easier to ask forgiveness than permission. Nobody is stopping you changing the documentation. Change it, please. Yeah?
If you can add something to your answer about communication channels, especially. But one of the problems with introducing new people to Drupal recently was that the channels that Drupal uses for communication with contributors and other people were kind of geeky and talking about diversity. And so people coming to new people coming to the how we can ask questions and where do you conversing? Like, I see. This is from 80s of last century, like 40 years ago. So, and then there were many discussions, and, including talking with people from WordPress communities and WordPress community and other WordPress communities. And they gave a very simple number when WordPress started to use Slack instead of IRC. And we don't know that Slack is bad because of programming technology, but still, after that, they have seen tenfold increase of new people coming to these communication channels compared to other sources. So, and this is now happens also to the community, the new channels.
Yeah, but on Slack, and don't be afraid to say things. Yeah, you all have something good to say. You all do. Yeah. Oh, sorry, yeah.
I have a different question. I really like the talking what you're saying. Reminds me of a talk by Mike Material, I don't know if you know him, LA based.
Yes, he's really bad, yeah.
Well, he has the same rant that goes on with all due respect about training your. It's a part of our whole industry, as we are. I've given this quite a lot of thought. And I think, or I have this issue. Where that sometimes, especially with the Drupal or that more complex coding, we tend to get into it. I mean, an agency thing, so when we get into it, we kind of lose the surplus of energy to train our juniors. I don't employ very nice people, but, we're also coders, when we get into it, we kind of get that narrow focus and there's deadlines, even though we're willing to shift to deadlines. We still lose it.
Do
you have any experience overcoming that thing? It's in those moments, it's the most important time to train humans when things get hard. The training, when it's all soft issues, does not have as much grip as when it's really hard.
You saw that? It literally is a case of constantly reminding yourself why you do it. Why it's important to spend that time and do all of those growth things. Why it's always important to be thinking, where am I going to take this person? How can I grow this person all the time? And I suppose the thing to remember is if people don't grow, if people don't change, they work with you, you'll always be in that situation. You'll never get out of it. So if you don't do something to change the situation, you'll always be there. Which I think is what that Einstein quote is about. If you do the same thing three times, then that's the and expect a different result, then that's the sign of madness or something. So remembering that you always need to be thinking, how do I improve my capabilities? And as a business owner, your capabilities are your personal ones and those of your people as well. Then as long as you're thinking, how am I shifting on by 1%? Of whatever that is, each little time, then that's okay. Of course, you're going to have weeks where you don't get much done because that's just reality. Yeah, but make sure that when you have the softer times, you take it even further and catch up. Yeah, the whole thing I'm talking about is using the extra. The extra opportunities outside of the work situation, like mentoring and core contribution, all those things, use those pretty much as learning exercises. So when you're planning, if you were a business owner and you were thinking, I'm going to take three people to DrupalCon, don't think I need someone to watch this session, and this session, because we need to know about Search API. Don't think we need to know about Search API. Think about how you're going to grow their capabilities for learning and their capabilities for growing as people. And that's why I'm talking about things like Friday, is because they could be doing anything. They could end up on the Search API table making Search API, which, to be honest, is better than sitting and talking. Yeah? So use. Yeah, I know. You use the time, but think about people rather than products, I would say. Sorry, I'm going on a bit now, so I'll shut up. I thought we lost about half an hour. Thank you. So, guys, I just want to say thank you all.
here. It's actually a low international event, almost. So we are very happy with this. It's our first event from this kind. And if you see guys like this and you want to give some feedback, ask questions, do. Thank you. We have 15 minutes coffee break and then we have the next session about Drupal.